Dear friends, let's deal with the issue of racism in Australia. Really? Are Aussies racist? Let me say this. I lived in Australia for the past 18 years and I have never, ever faced racism. I've traveled the length and breadth of the country, possibly more than many people who are watching this clip. Met with thousands of Aussies from all walks of life, have been felt so loved, embraced, connected, and welcoming. Actually, I want to thank the nation of Australia for opening their arms wide to let people from all countries come here. But what ticks me off is this. When our government and our media constantly attacks an Aussie, if he or she gets up and says, "I'm proud to be an Australian, I love my country," immediately they got to be a racist. What a load of garbage is this? What's wrong in being proud about your nation? What's wrong in being patriotic about your nation? On the contrary, I will actually encourage you and challenge you to be so. If you lose your patriotism, if you lose your passion and pride about your nation, that's when a nation is on the road to destruction. Because then any and everyone who comes into the country tells the host nation how to run their countries. Let me tell you, our politicians are gutless, backboneless, politically correct puppets who are serving this country right now, many of them. Why they bend head over heels to please Islam and multiculturalism, neglecting their own very country people. In 2002 or 2003, around that time, there were many cases which were brought to the courts on racist charges. Why? Because the Equal Opportunity Commission trained 500 Arab descent people to go and find out how they are getting verified, or taught them how to bring a complaint. Let me put this to you. If a white Australian tries to complain to the Equal Opportunity Commission about racism, guess what? The complaint is not even accepted. But if a black fellow, like myself, takes a complaint, a non-white, immediately they'll promote the complaint, question the person concerned, bring the person, make that person apologize, and that person is shut up for the rest of their life. We cannot let this happen. I stand with the nation of Australia and I will defend the right to be patriotic and proud about our nation. So what's the problem? The problem is politically correct politicians and the media is selling our nation out. This is why in the next federal election, you should not be voting Liberal or Labour. Because, and the Greens, they are the worst traitors. They are the worst traitors, the Greens. Yes, I'm talking about the Greens. Because they have nothing else but to betray their own country. The UN is another major problem. The UN wants to take all the rights of independent sovereign nations, and our current government leaders are bending head over heels to sign away our country's freedoms to a foreign body called the UN. I want to challenge every Australian to stand up for their nation. Do not fear, do not back off. If you are not a racist, stand your ground and say, "I love my nation, I'm patriotic about my nation, I'm proud about my nation. If you come here, you're most welcome, but don't try to shut me up. If you try to shut me up and if you try to change my style of living or my way of life in Australia, go back to where you came from." This is your right to say this. I myself, I've been a victim of racism. I know what it is to be a victim of racism. My mother and father were almost burnt alive on tires in 1983, right in front of my own eyes. Many of my relations had their houses burned. So don't try to tell me what is racism. I know what racism is. I've been a victim. Many people come with a victim mentality. Fortunately, I came out of the victim mentality and I understood that how my outlook in life makes a big difference for the future. What's happened in the past, we can't live in the past. We've got to look at the future and start working as together, united, towards the future. So I want to challenge people who come into this country. Don't sit within your community and have this "help me please" pity party mentality. Break out of that mindset. Don't imagine or think just because you have come from a minority group, possibly from another country, that just because you see white Australians in Australia and they are the majority, that automatically they are racist. No, they're not. I was told that when I first came. I believed that for the first few months, but quickly I woke up to reality and I realized it's not about what my country can do for me, but what I can do for my country. So I want to challenge everyone who's watching this video. Rise up. I'm the national president of Rise Up Australia Party. My mission, my vision, my ambition is to keep Australia Australian for generations to come. This Saturday, the 12th of December, a 12-meet day, I will be speaking at the Cronulla 10th Memorial in Sydney, New South Wales. Be there, be a part of this occasion. This is not a race riot. This is about bringing reconciliation and calling on all Aussies to unite against the common threat of Islam. I'm even calling on Muslims to come to the rally. If you know that your religion is peaceful, then come against those who are evil. You join us, you're welcome. Let's unite together as a nation, not as different groups, but as one people united, we stand, divided we fall. And then let's attack those parts of Islam and Islamic fundamentalists who are trying to destroy our way of life. This rally is not a race riots rally. This rally is to celebrate reconciliation, love, and unity. Be there Saturday the 12th of December, 12 midday. Thank you.